If you're looking at streaming music, movies, or calls from your phone, your laptop, or your TV to your Signia hearing aids, you will have to pick up a Streamline mic. The Signia Streamline mic is basically compatible with all Bluetooth connected hearing aids from Signia, which can already connect with iPhone. So if you are an Android user or looking to use it with your laptop for Zoom calls or looking to stream from your TV, I would highly recommend checking out this full review of the Streamline mic, its features and functions, and whether this is the right device for you. Alright, so firstly I wanted to show you how to get your Signia hearing aids connected to your Streamline mic, and then further how to get your Streamline mic connected to your Android phone. So firstly what you want to do is you want to turn on the Streamline mic by holding the multifunction button. It's the biggest button on the side, and you will see that the green light turns on and the yellow light starts blinking. So what this means is that the Streamline mic is looking for some hearing aids. So if you take your hearing aids out of the case and wait a few seconds, you will see that the blinking stops. Sorry, it's a bit overexposed. The blinking stops there, meaning that your hearing aids have now connected with your Streamline mic. So once these two are connected together, we can then connect it to our phone, laptop, or TV. In this example, I'm going to be connecting it to my Android phone and just showing you the steps on how to get it connected. So the first thing you want to do is you want to put your Streamline mic into pairing mode. How you do this is by pressing that same multifunction button as well as the volume up. You want to be pressing and holding until the yellow light turns blue. Awesome. So now it's flashing blue. It's in pairing mode. We can go to your Android phone, swipe down from the top, and click on the settings tab. From there, you should be able to go to a tab which has Bluetooth on it. On my Samsung phone, it's under connections and Bluetooth. We want to be turning on your Bluetooth and begin scanning. So if you scroll down to the bottom of the page, and after a while you should see the Streamline mic pop up. So we can see the Streamline mic is down here now. We can click on it and start pairing. It will ask you whether you want to pair with the Streamline mic 1.1. Press OK and you will now be connected. You can see that when a Bluetooth device is connected, it glows in blue. So now you can stream whatever music, movies, or calls from your phone to your Signia hearing aids. Also, if you want to hear some unique stories about the audiology industry, check out my Hear Me Out podcast over in the link in the description. The Streamline mic has three primary functions. Firstly, as a remote control for your hearing aids. As you can see, there are three program buttons. So the multifunction button, which allows you to switch between different programs on your hearing aids, as well as the volume up and volume down. This is especially useful for devices like the Signia Stiletto hearing aids, which don't have any program buttons. So you can use this as a remote control. The second function is using it as a remote mic. So for example, if you're in a restaurant situation and it's really noisy, you would turn this on and put it on your partner across the table from you. And this microphone over here would be picking up the signal from their voice and helping you to hear them much more clearer. From my experience, it doesn't work that well as a remote mic. It's a bit noisy and a bit quiet at times, but my main use of this Streamline mic is as a Bluetooth streamer. So I just really wanted to go through some of the pros and cons of the Streamline mic as a streamer. Signia claims that the Streamline mic lasts 6 hours on a 2-hour charge. And from my experience, it does last quite long. It is kind of annoying that you do have to charge it maybe once or twice a day, depending on how much streaming you're doing. One of the things I love about it though, is that you are able to keep it on charge, especially when you're taking a lot of Zoom calls on your computer all day long. So that's what I've been doing, just leaving it on charge and going about my day. And in my opinion, the convenience of being able to stream calls directly from your phone to your hearing aids highly outweighs having to charge it all the time and the additional cost, which is around $300 to $500 on top of the cost of the hearing aids itself. When playing music and movies, you are also able to use it as a media control to raise or lower your volume and also pause your music, which is super convenient. One annoying thing though is that you can't use it to replay music. So no matter how many times you press the multifunction button, it won't start your music again. You will have to go and open the app again and press play. The reason for this is it reverts to the remote control function of changing the programs for your hearing aids once you stop playing music from your phone. One more annoying thing about the Streamline Mic or any other Bluetooth device on Windows is that although you are able to stream sound into your hearing aids, often it doesn't allow you to stream the mic the other direction. This is not an issue when you're using your phone or a MacBook, but when using Windows, you will have to use your onboard microphone or use a lavalier mic like this from eBay. In summary, if you're looking at connecting your Bluetooth connected hearing aids to your Android phone, TV, or laptop, I would highly recommend picking up a Streamline Mic to make your life much more easy. Thank you so much for watching this episode of Hearing Tech News with Mark Truong. If you want to find out how to get the best music streaming quality out of your Signia hearing aids, check out my full tutorial in the card above. Otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you on the next video.